After the last update of the AI-generated content guideline of Amazon, I decided to make more videos about Adobe Illustrator for Amazon KDP to help my audience build a more sustainable business model. Amazon may be more strict about AI-generated content publishing soon. Besides this, I think the Amazon algorithm will apply more weight to human-generated content while calculating the product scores and give more visibility to them. Therefore, if you are serious about KDP business, I strongly recommend learning professional design tools like Adobe Illustrator. If you don't know about Adobe Illustrator, it is a vector-based graphics software. I know that sounds scary for some of you, but don't worry. There is no need to have any previous knowledge for this tutorial series. Just get your 7-day free trial and follow me. The 7-day free trial link is below in the description, and let's get started. When you open the Adobe Illustrator, you get this start page. Click the New File button on the left. Okay, you can define the dimensions, measurement units, number of artboards, that means page numbers, and color mode of your document here. Before entering the width and height values of your requested paper size here, I would like to explain to you quickly a confusing point for beginners. It is bleed imprinting. As it is quite difficult to print exactly to the edges of a paper, printers print a slightly larger area than is needed and then trim the paper down to the required physical product size. So, this extra space around the outside of your paper that will be cut off during the production is called bleed. When you upload your interior to Amazon KDP, there are options to upload with no bleed and bleed. However, don't forget, all book covers on KDP require bleed. Whenever you have a background, image, or illustration that is intended to extend to the edge of the page, you must set your document by considering the bleed margins. Otherwise, you will have a thin white border around the edges after the printing process. I always set my document with bleed margins. I advise you to do the same. By the way, you can find all the necessary information about setting trim sizes, bleeds, and margins on the KDP Help Center. The most common trim size for books in the United States is 6x9 inches. Here, there is an example of a bleed manuscript layout for a 6x9 inch book. The blue rectangular shows 6 inches by 9 inches trim size, which means the final size of the physical book. Bleeds in the United States generally are 0.125 inches from the top, bottom, and outside edges. So let's calculate our document size with bleed margins for 6 inches by 9 inches trim size. The width must be 6 inches plus 0.125 inches, the outside edge on the right side, equals 6.125 inches. If we make the same calculation for the height must be 9 inches plus 0.125 inches, the top edge, plus 0.125 inches, the bottom edge, equals 9.25 inches. So, we should set our document size as 6.125 by 9.25 inches in Adobe Illustrator. You don't have to make manual calculations each time like this when you define your document size with bleed. There is a chart on the KDP Help Center webpage with all the necessary information. If you go to the KDP Help Center, click Format your paperback on the left menu. Then, click Set Trim Size, Bleed and Margins under this link. If you scroll down to the end of the page, there is a chart that shows the available page sizes in KDP in the Bleed menu. Click the link to open this chart. Okay. Here, you can see the with and without bleed dimensions of each page size. For example, if you check the 6 by 9 inches trim size, the page size with bleed is 6.125 by 9.25 inches, which is the same as our calculation. So, you can find all the page sizes with bleed information on this chart for different trim sizes available on Amazon KDP. Please be aware that your trim size not only determines the physical book size, but also the minimum and maximum number of page counts in the book. You can also find this information on the same page of the KDP Help Center. There is a chart in Trim Size menu for this. Here, you can find minimum and maximum page count information for different trim sizes of both paperbacks and hardcovers. I will put the link to the KDP Help Center below in the description. I advise you to check it if you are a beginner in KDP business. Now, we can turn back to the start page of Adobe Illustrator and enter the width and height values to create our first document. As an example, I will create the document for 6 inches by 9 inches trim size. However, you can choose your trim size based on the type of book you are creating. For example, larger sizes like 8.5 by 11 or 8.5 by 8.5 would be more suitable for children's books. You can check the search results of your targeted keywords, read reviews of customers for your competitors' books, and then decide the best trim size for your book. On the top menu, you can choose the print option to have the closer settings you need for Amazon KDP. For example, if you select the print option, the color mode is pre-selected as CMYK. However, you can change it to CMYK in other options as well. First of all, change the measurement units to inches. As I said, I will create my document with bleed margins. Therefore, the width is 6.125 inches and the height is 9.25 inches. The orientation type is selected as portrait, so it's okay. Here, you should write the number of artboards that you would like to create. It means the page count of your book. For the moment, I will create only one page to show you some details in Adobe Illustrator. However, we will create documents with more pages and work on them in the following tutorials. As we included the bleed margin above, we don't need to add any bleed margin in this area. Under the Advanced Options menu, you should always select CMYK color mode. RGB mode is used for digital designs like web, TV, or phone files. On the other hand, the design files that are intended for print should be designed in CMYK mode. Therefore, we should always use CMYK mode in our files. It is indicated also in the KDP Help Center for covers. Images should be in CMYK color to ensure your cover looks good in print. All images should be sized at 100%, flattened to one layer, and placed in your document at a minimum resolution of 300 dpi dots per inch. So, as they indicated here, for raster effects, you should always choose high 300 ppi. Then, click Create. Okay, our first page is ready now. Today's tutorial was just an introduction for beginners. I will introduce quickly the workspace and show you how to create your first interior file to upload to Amazon KDP step by step in the following video. Therefore, if you don't have Adobe Illustrator, or struggled with it before, get your 7-day free trial from the link below in the description and be ready for the next tutorial. See you soon!